Welcome to the ROES Events tutorial for simple use. This tutorial will show you how to create a job in Events without using a spreadsheet and instead utilizing the tools inherent to Events. First, navigate to Events and create a job by clicking on the plus mark in the lower left corner. Double-click on the newly created job row and name your job appropriately. With your new job highlighted, click Subject Info in the lower right corner to move to the next step. In the first section, choose Create an Empty Table to Use and click Next. Type in the number of subjects for your project, I have 6 subjects, and then the number of fields you will be using, I have 7 fields. Some good field names are file name, first name, last name, grade, team, group picture, and packages. The file name and packages rows are required. You can always add more subjects and fields later if you forgot any. Select Next. Choose the package group you will use for this project and select Next. If you haven't created packages, check out the tutorial video for building package favorites in ROES. Select Yes to navigate to your folder of images and select Next. Browse to the folder that contains your images, select an individual image, and click Open. And then Next. Now you'll see your images in an empty data sheet on one page in Events. Your images will appear in alphabetical or sequential order. If you click on Add Remove, you can select Add Column if you forgot a subject or Add Row if you forgot a field. Now let's name the field names. Double-click on the field name and type in the appropriate field definition for each. Properly formatted data will be included on the package label for each of your subject orders. Your orders will be packaged in the order they appear on the spreadsheet. For the file name field, find the corresponding image in your thumbnails and drag the image to the file name field for that subject. Start entering your subject information. Hit Enter on your keyboard after you're done, and the cursor will move to the next field for the subject. When you get to the Group Picture field, drag in your group image to the Group Picture row. If the group picture is the same for all of your subjects, right-click on the group picture and select Make Group Image. Select the Image Row field name for the group picture from the drop-down menu, then select Next and type in the number of remaining records for your subject, in this case 5, and select OK. The group photo is now copied to all subjects in your data. On the packages row, make sure you type the package name exactly as it appears in your package group, followed by a hyphen and the quantity for that package. In this case, I will type A, then a hyphen and quantity of 1. If more than one package is ordered for a subject, type in the package and quantity in the same fashion, followed by a semicolon, and then the package and quantity for the subsequent package. Continue typing in the rest of your data and match your images to the appropriate subjects. Your data will be saved continuously, and you can always come back to the project later to finish. Once all data is entered, you need to associate your packages field in Events. Click on the packages field name to highlight the entire packages row. Click on the Use as Packages button. All correctly typed fields will be highlighted in green, and anything incorrect or empty will be pink. If you see a pink field, double check that the information is entered in the appropriate format and that there is a package by that name in your favorites group. Check out the tutorial video assigning fields to packages for the next step, and then reviewing and submitting your order to finalize your order. Pro tip. Click on the Images button at the bottom of the page and select Add Images to add all of your images to the first row of your data. This will create a record for every image in your Images folder, including the group image. You can now associate your group image to your group picture section, just as before, and then you can remove the group image by right-clicking and selecting Remove Column.